Hello everyone, I am Aryan Gupta, a student of Cluster Innovation Center, and today I am going to be talking about my GSOC project that I have completed in 2020 under the Mission Support System Organization, which is present under the umbrella organization of Python Software Foundation. Firstly, I would like to talk about my organization, which is the Mission Support System. So Mission Support System is an open source flight planning software which is used by scientists in the field of atmospheric science. The scientists use this software to visualize flight plans on the basis of the present and existing atmospheric conditions. My project is enhancing KML support. For those who don't know about KML, KML stands for Keyhole Markup Language, and it was invented by Google, and it is just like an XML notation, but it is specific for generating geographical data, and this data can then be used for parsing and visualization within 2D maps as well as 3D browsers. One of the main popular examples which use KML is Google Earth, where we can upload a KML file and the Google Earth browser passes the data and then shows us the visualization on the Google Earth platform. So my project originally involved redesigning and implementing a better UI to display multiple KML files, and that too simultaneously. I would like to show you what all I have done. Okay. Firstly, I would like to show you the work that was done before I started my project. So this is the top view of the Mission Support System. This is the map. I have opened the world map. In this picture, I had opened the world map for displaying the data. As you can see, this is the KML overlay doc widget that I had to work on. Originally, only one file could be added and only one file could be loaded, and you could change the color of only that file. And this was very cumbersome and annoying because there is a lot of data present in different files, and you cannot just go along putting one file after the another. So it's better if you could visualize all of them simultaneously on the same map. Here's an overview of how it looked originally. This is the KML overlay doc widget that was present originally. As you can see, it's written experimental feature, and not all KML files will work because the backend of this KML doc widget wasn't that strong to support all the files that could be made using KML. So this was my project that I had to work on, and now I would like to show you my project. Firstly, setting up my virtual environment. And now I'm running the software. So this is how the Mission Support System looks. I will be opening the top view, which is present right here. In this top view, I will be working with KML overlay doc widget. I'm going to change this to global. So this is how the KML overlay looks right now. And as you can see, there are a lot of buttons here and a button right here. There's a list widget here and a status bar. So one of my main work that I had to do was redesign and re-implement a better UI. So I have tried to create a minimal UI which would only require the buttons that are really necessary, and I have removed the others. So this is the select all button because it selects all the files. This is for adding KML files. This is for removing the files which are ticked, and this is for unselecting the files. This function is for merging and exporting KML file. This means that if you have like 10 files that you are working with, you could merge them into a single file. So the next time you try to work on it, you will only have to open a single file. As you can see, the status bar says click on add KML files to get started. Okay. So these are the sample KML files that I have. I will be using this to demonstrate how the KML overlay doc widget works. So firstly, I'll be selecting one file. As you can see, the second I selected this file, the plot opened up right on the map. You did not have to click on any other button. I have also added a small check bar here. How this works is simply that if you uncheck it, the plot will vanish, and if you check it again, the plot will appear. This is very useful when you have a lot of files and you want to see some data but not the other. I will be showing it to you pretty soon. So I added one file at that time. Maybe I'll add two files this time. So I have added three files here. Maybe I do not want to see the folder.kml file for right now. So I can uncheck it and that plot will vanish. But that plot is present and you can check it to see it again anytime. However, doesn't this look quite crowded and you know they are all are the same colors, there's no space here, and I don't think it's displaying the exact data that we wanted or in a form that could be well interpreted. So I have also created this simple dialog. When you double click on any file, it will open a specific customize KML file option. In that, you can customize the color of the file and you can also change the line width of the file. By line width, I mean the thickness of the plot that has been drawn on the map. I will be choosing orange for line.kml, and please focus on the map as well so you will see real-time change in the data or in the plot that has been plotted. As you can see, the line width is now much more smaller. I can do the same for other files as well. I will keep the folder.kml as yellow. And now I'll be making this. This looks nice. And a bit thin. So now this is at 3 and this is how it looks. I can still unplot it, plot it and all. Maybe I want to remove one of these files and therefore I will click on remove files and it will remove it. It remove file only removes the files that are checked and then I can still continue working with the rest of my files. The select all files button can be seen simply as this. If I click on unselect all, it will unselect all of the files. If I select all, it will select all the files. This is useful because if you're working with a large amount of files, you can just click on select all files and remove if you want to remove all of them. Next, I will try to open one more. I'll open this again. So here we have three different files, and now if I want to merge it into a single file, I can easily do so. I will click on merge and it gives a default name. So I would like to change this to new file .kml and I save it. And since all the files are already selected, I can click on remove files. It removes the files from the list widget. It also removes the files from the plot. Now we'll try to go and add the KML file. Here is the file that I have created. So if I open it, all these files are present. And they are present all in a single KML file. So that is a very useful function here. So as you can see, I have talked about the basic front end. Now I would like to show you how capable the system is of running KML files. So one of my main features was adding fast KML support to the current implementation. So fast KML is a library which is used to parse KML data, and it's a very effective and easy to use library. So a lot of KML files have different types of data present. That may include geometries as well as styles. So I used FastKML to add support for a large number of styles as well as all the geometries that are present. So all the KML files can now run without crashing in our software. For example, I would like to show you some examples that I've got. So this worldmap.kml is a test sample that I have obtained from NASA open data sets, and as you will see, it is created of multiple multi-polygons. So it is a specific kind of geometry, and to parse it is quite important because a large number of files can contain this. So what this does is it creates the entire map that is present through polygons. So all of these things that you see, these are all polygons. You can use this and you can zoom it and you can see that this is forming a polygon. And like I've said, this is a fun feature. You can still change the color and everything, and it changes and it looks very nice. I have added other files as well, which I will show you. This one is called polygoninner.kml, and this is a specific type of geometry in which you can draw polygons inside another polygons. So this is, as you can see, this is how it looks on zooming. I will try to see if I have other files as well. Yeah, this is a multiline strings.kml. So what this does is it plots a number of line strings, and all of these line strings are multiline strings, that is, they are also all connected, as you can see, like this. So I'll be removing these files and I'll be going back. So this is all the front end as well as the back end that I have created for KML files, and this is very useful, and it will be very useful in the coming years because flight planning requires a lot of processing and thinking, and this software helps make good decisions. So now I've closed the software. Lastly, I would just like to go through my documentation, which has everything that I have done. So these are the features that I've added. I have added a minimal UI KML overlay. I have added support for displaying multiple KML files on the map and simultaneously. There's a customization option for each and every line KML file for their specific line width and color. I showed you the toggle feature to display and hide the plot of individual KML files. I showed you the merge KML file options to combine KML files into a single file. I also told you about the fast KML support that I've added, which can parse all geometries and specific styles of KML specification. I have added excellent test samples, and I've written great tests to test out the capabilities of my fast KML implementation and relevant minor fixes to improve the user experience of KML overlay. So this is all about my GSO project that I've done from May 2020 to, I guess, August 2020. So thanks for listening. Thank you.